This is the latest model in the iQOO Neo 10 series, the Neo 10 Pro Plus. It features the Snapdragon 8 Gen 2 Leading Edition processor, paired with iQOO's self-developed gaming chip Q2. It is equipped with a 6800 mAh battery and supports 120 watts fast charging. It comes with a 120 watts charging set. The charger's model is V12060L1H3CN. It supports a maximum output of 20 volts 6 amps via the proprietary protocol, as well as 100 watts PD at 20 volts 5 amps and PPS output ranging from 5 volts to 20 volts at up to 5 amps. The manufacturer is AOHI. The length of the dual USB-C cable is about 1 meter. The maximum supported current is 6 amps. ChargerLab Power ZKM003C shows it supports UFCS 44 watt, QC 2.0, PD 3.0, DCP, and PPS charging protocols. It features a 6.82-inch 2K display with a resolution of 3168 by 1440 and a pixel density of 510 ppi. The peak brightness is up to 4500 nits. On the rear, it features a dual camera setup consisting of a 50MP main camera and an 8MP ultra-wide-angle lens. According to the official introduction, when paired with the 120 watts charger, it can charge up to 70% in 25 minutes and is also compatible with 100 watt PPS. Additionally, it supports direct power supply to help protect the battery. It also supports features like optimized battery charging to extend the battery's lifespan. Next, let's do the charging compatibility test. Using the iQOO chargers for testing, the lowest charging power recorded is 40.69 watts, and the highest reaches 99.75 watts. All four chargers rated above 120 watts can deliver nearly 100 watts. Move to the third-party chargers. Its compatibility is excellent. The charging power is mainly concentrated at several levels, 15 to 18 watts, 20 to 30 watts, 35 to 50 watts, and 70 to 85 watts. The highest charging power is 82.4 watts. It has a low entry barrier for charger selection, enhancing the overall charging experience. We use the original charger to charge it fully and put them into a 25 degrees Celsius thermotank throughout the test. The voltage is around 17 volts at first. The charging curve can be divided into 7 parts. The peak power is around 99 watts for the first 42 seconds. Then, the power gradually drops to 76 watts, 60 watts, 49 watts, 45 watts, and 30 watts in turn. During the process, the voltage drops to 9 volts. The final part begins at 32 minutes, and the power drops to almost zero. It takes 42 minutes to be fully charged. It reaches 50% in 16 minutes. And it can reach 80% in 26 minutes, 100% in 42 minutes. We also recorded the highest temperature on the front and back after charging for 10 minutes, 20 minutes, and 30 minutes. After 10 minutes, the maximum temperature on the front is 35.9 degrees Celsius. The back is 36.3 degrees Celsius. After 20 minutes, the maximum temperature on the front is 36.3 degrees Celsius. The back is 36.5 degrees Celsius. After 30 minutes, the maximum temperature on the front is 33.7 degrees Celsius. The back is 34.1 degrees Celsius. During charging for 30 minutes, the temperature is between 33.7 and 36.5 degrees Celsius. Combined with the power curve, it can be seen that the charging power remains consistently high throughout the process. The thermal management performs very well. Overall, the iQOO Neo 10 Pro Plus excels in performance, display, battery life, and imaging experience. Its 6800 mAh battery paired with 120 watts fast charging can reach 80% charge in 26 minutes and fully charge in 42 minutes, offering impressive speed. It also performs well in compatibility, supporting third-party high-voltage PPS fast charging with power exceeding 80 watts, delivering an excellent charging experience. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye.